Hi, yes, we are teachers, lifelong learners. I welcome you back in our YouTube channel. Today, we are going to practice some MCQs based on the B.Ed. course 201, Quality and Management of School Education, Unit Number 1, Part 1. And today, we are going to cover different topics, and the topics are management concept, modern theories of management, types of management, in that time management, event management, and classroom management. So let's have practice of MCQs. This is question number one, and the question is, management is management of people, not things. It emphasizes personal management, and this definition of management is given by, and the options are A. James, B. F.W. Taylor, C. Holy, and D. Henry Fayol. So In your final examination also, as university has decided to conduct your final examination through online mode, and the pattern will be MCQ pattern only. So there may be chances to ask such type of questions, and how to remember name of the author of the particular definitions. So for that, you have to give emphasis on, you have to just recall the things that particular author give emphasis on the particular things. For example, here, the main emphasis is given on the personal management and the management of the people. And the correct option for this question is yes. And the option A, it is the correct option. So I'm going to log this option. So let's see various definitions given by the Taylor, by Holy, by Henry Fayol. We have already discussed about the definition of management given by the Henry Fayol, and whatever functions of management given by Henry Fayol, he put emphasis on those functions, means to manage, means to forecast, to plan, to control. So whatever functions included in the definitions are the functions given by the Henry Fayol. Yes, manage according to Holy. So what about Holy? Yes. So according to Holy, management, it is a continuous process. You have to remember that management is the continuous process, and through which members of an organization seek to coordinate their activities and utilize their resources in order to fulfill the various tasks of the organization as efficiently as possible. So basically, Holy, he gave emphasis on the continuous process. Management, it is a continuous process. Then what about the Taylor? Yes. So here, the Taylor, according to Taylor, management, it is the art. It is the art of knowing exactly what you want to do and seeing that they do in the best and cheapest way. So these are the different definitions given by the different authors, right? And you have to just remember that the key concept, or you can say the emphasis given on the particular things. So according to James give emphasis on the personal management or the management of the people. Taylor give emphasis on the management, it is the art. According to Holy, the management, it is the process, it is a continuous process. And according to Fayol, the management are nothing but the implementation of the different functions of management. Yes. The next question is, yes, see, both the questions, mean the question number first and this question number two, and I think one or two more questions I took from the book, that is School Administration and Management by S.K. Coacher, which is really nice book. I think every teacher should have that book. Yes. The question is, Practical Handbook of School Management by Teachers, authored by ... in 1872. And the options are Peter Drucker, Henry Fayol, Harding, and none of the above. So see the question again, Practical Handbook of the School Management by Teachers, authored by, and the correct answer is, yes, and the correct answer is Harding. So here, again, the different question, there may be chances to ask different question based on the same. They can give the name of the author and they will ask about the year. So please remember in which year Harding, he authored the book, that is Practical Handbook of School Management by Teachers. So this question, again, this question I took from the same book, that is the Coach's book, SK Coach's book. Scope of educational management divided into inputs, input, process, and output. Arrange following shuffled words, or not only the words, but the group of words also are here, in the proper sequence to explain scope of educational management. And see, the words are the planning, human resources, and all-round development. So according to the input, process, and output, we are going to arrange this word. And the options are all-round development, planning, human resources. Option number B is planning, all-round development, human resources. Option C is planning, human resources, all-round development. Option D is human resources, planning, and all-round development. Now, we are going to arrange these words in the sequence, that is input, process, and output. So now, which is the correct option? And here the correct option is option number D, that is human resources, planning, all-round development. See, because as you know that all-round development, so there can be the aesthetic development, there can be the cultural development, intellectual development, moral development, social development, physical development. And in short, we can say it combined as an all-round development. So that will be the output of the, see, in the sequence, the input, process, and output. So this will be the output. Yes. Then human resources, these are the inputs. So here, not only the human resources, but there are many other inputs. Means the, in what comes under human resources, the student, teachers, parents, even the management committee members, all these things comes under the human resources. But apart from that, there are so many inputs like the funding, like the machineries, the furniture, stationery, even the whatever teaching methods used for the teaching, whatever evaluation methods, everything comes under the input. And what about the process? Whatever functions of management are there, all the functions like planning, organizing, staffing, directing, coordinating, reporting, budgeting, all these functions, they comes under the process of management. So according to the scope in the sequence, that is input, process, and output. So whatever words are given here, so option number D is the correct, because here the human resources, they are the input, planning, it is the type of process, and the final output will be the all-round development. The option, next question is, educational management is a distinct process consisting of, please remember that in previous questions, we have already studied about the process, what comes under the processes, okay? Because the scope of management, it's given in the format, that is input, process, and output. So here the question is, educational management is a distinct process consisting of option number A, planning, B, organizing, C, actuating and controlling, and all of the above. So automatically all the functions, they comes under the processes of management. So here we are going to lock option number 4, that is option number D, all of the above. The next question is, find out or man out from the following group of words: organizing, planning, controlling, coordinating, staffing, cooperating, innovating, leading. So from this group of words, we have to find out the odd man out, which is the odd word from this group of words. And the options are A, staffing, B, innovating, C, leading, and option D, that is cooperating. If we see, so these are the functions of management. So which is not a function of management, we are going to find out that option, and that will be odd man out. Yes. So from this question, we are going to select option number B, that is innovating, which is odd man out, because this innovating, it is not a function of management. Yes. If you are new on the channel, then please subscribe this channel and don't forget to press on bell button so that you will get notification of upcoming videos. If you like this video, please like it. share with your friends, because the knowledge should be always shared with everyone. And if you like this video, please comment on the comment box. If you want to give any suggestion to me, please give your suggestions also. And if you want any video on any new topic, please write your topic in your comment box. Yes. So let's have drilling on some more MCQs. This is very simple question. Henry Fiol identified dash principles of management, and the options are A 12, B 14, C 15, D 16. And the correct option is, of course, the correct option is option number B, that is 14, because total 14 principles of management are given by Henry Fiol. The interest of one employee should not be allowed to become more important than those of the group. This principle of management is called as, so you can see that this is one description of one principle which is given by the Henry Fiol. And in the options also, you can see the different name of the different principles given by the Henry Fiol. So the options are: A is the centralization, B is division of work, C is stability of tenure, and D is subordination of individual interest to general interest. Okay, so we should know the meaning of different principles. Centralization, this is related to the decision making, and decisions are always taken by the higher level authority in the centralization decision making process. The second is division of work. So here the main task is divided into different small tasks. And the third is stability of tenure. It is related to the job stability and job security. And the fourth is subordination of individual interest to general interest. Means here, and the, so here automatically we are going to select the option number four as a, that is option number D as a correct option, because the meaning of the subordination of individual interest to general interest, it is given here. So interest of one employee should not be allowed to become more important than those of the groups. Means always in the first priority, the first importance should be given to the group of people, to the institutions, not by the particular employee. Okay, this is the main, the basic meaning of the subordination of individual interest to general interest. Yes, so let's move ahead. Fiol emphasized on the need for teamwork in completing objectives, and in the principle, in union there is a strength. What term did Fiol use for expressing this? So again, this is related to one principle. This question is related to a principle given by the Henry Fiol. And you can see different options here. Okay. And if we see the meaning of esprit de corps, it is that in union there is a strength. So automatically we are going to select option number A as a correct option. And I think you know that what is meaning of coordination and the division of the work. So automatically we are going to eliminate these two, option number B and C. And the exact meaning of the esprit de corps, it is in union there is a strength. So which options we are supposed to lock? Yes, option number A, that is esprit de corps. Henry Fiol, and the durations are given here. And these durations are nothing but the birth year and death year of the particular theorist. So here we are talking about the Henry Fiol. And if we see the duration of the Henry Fiol according to the birth year and the death year, it is, yes, it is 1841 to 1925. So here we are going to log option number A, that is correct option. The same question is related to the Peter Drucker. And again, we are going to log the option number. Yes, of course, we are not going to log the option number, say the same option for this, because the duration, it is different. And for this question, the duration is, yes, the C option is the correct option. And the duration is 1909 to 2005. Peter Drucker introduced a theory of management, and it is called as, and the options are management by objectives, management by participation, management by results, and all of the above. Yes, so it is, see, Peter Drucker's theory It is also called as management by objective. There are some more names for this theory, that is management by participation, management by result, and one more name is there, that is management by goals. So we are going to lock option number D, that is the correct option. So next question, this question, it is also related to the Peter Drucker's theory. According to the Peter Drucker, goals can be short term, long term, integration of individual and institutional goals, and all of the above. So here we are going to lock option number 4, that is all of the above, because according to Peter Drucker, the goals can be short term, long term as well, and there should be integration of individual and institutional goals. So here we have already locked option number D, that is all of the above. This is one challenging question for you, okay, because you may get confusion while selecting the correct option. Students who stand first in examinations are motivated and praised by teacher to perform better and consistently again. Is an example of motivation, option number A. Option number B, that is motivation process involved in MBA. The C, it is both, and D, none of the above. So first, maybe we think that this is a part of motivation, of course. So whatever statement is given here, it is related to the, it is an example of motivation. But if you remember, if you recall the processes involved in MBO, that is the management by objective, the theory of Peter Drucker's theory, we can say. So in that, in the processes of MBO, there is a one process, that is motivation. Okay. So this example is related to the motivation and motivation process involved in MBO. So here we are going to lock option number 3, that is both option number C. Effective classrooms characterized by the expectation of success. B, a highly effective climate. C, open architecture. D, an authoritarian climate. So what will the characteristic of effective classroom? So here we are going to, what we are going to eliminate? We are going to eliminate that first two options, that is option number B and option number D. So there should not be effective climate. There should not be authoritarian, means the autocratic climate. There should not be bossing, right? So from this option number A and C, we are going to select one. So if we see which is the closer to the answer, so automatically we're going to select the option number A, that is the correct option, the expectation of success. So this can be a characteristics of effective classroom. Yes, this question is the primary goal of effective classroom management is, and the options are an orderly classroom, to reduce misbehavior, C, to prevent misbehavior, to promote learning. Okay, so here also we are going to eliminate first two options, that is option number B and C. See, the classroom or effective classroom management, it is not the primary goal. See, of course, if you see the all options are related to effective classroom management, but here the question is related to the primary goal. Yes, so automatically we are going to eliminate option number B and C, because the primary goal is not to reduce misbehavior or to prevent misbehavior. So from option number A and D, we are going to select one option. And the options are an orderly classroom, and the D is the promote learning. So automatically from these two, we are going to select option number D, that is to promote learning. It is the primary goal of effective classroom management. Yes, so I have locked this option number D. Classroom management principles are applied differently in elementary and secondary school, because the options are, teachers are trained differently. B, schools are structured differently at these levels. C, the administrative organization changes at these levels. And D, they are not applied differently across elementary and secondary schools. So out of these four options, you have to select one. Now, let's have elimination. Okay, so which options we are going to eliminate? Two management principles applicable differently in the elementary and secondary schools. So elementary schools means the primary schools. So whatever principles are there of classroom management, they apply differently. So principles are the same, but the application, it changes as per the level of the school, we can say, that is elementary and the secondary school. So here, if we see the option number D, it is totally contrast of the statement. So first, we supposed to think about the first three options. Yes. So out of these three options, just focus on the option number C, that is the administrative organization changes at this level. So this is not true regarding this. So automatically we are going to eliminate this option number C. So let's see that option number A and B, they are related to the statement. Yes. So here the teachers are trained differently. See, there are different principles of the classroom management. The principles are same, but the applicability is different. So again, we are going to eliminate this option number A, that is teachers are trained differently, because all teacher trainees, they learn the same principles, but the application as per the level, it is different. So again, we are going to eliminate the option number A. Yes. So let's see about, let's think about the option number B. Schools are structured differently at this level. Yes. So schools are structured differently as at this level means what? If we see the structure of the school building, even the timetable, structure of the timetable, in between, if we see that the primary level, the duration is less, and the some periods like craft period, the music period, the computer period, they are added frequently in between the two mentally, what you can say, the high high intellectual subject, we can say. So applicability of principle, it is different level wise. So we are going to lock this option number B as correct option. Schools are structured differently at these levels. So here I'm going to lock option number B, that is correct option. Schools are structured differently at these levels. That dealing of MCQs, it is important, but the main thing is you have to, your understanding about the different concept, it should be proper, because like the theory papers for MCQ paper means MCQ pattern exam, again the paper setters, they are going to set the paper based on the different objectives like knowledge, understanding and application, and equage weightage will be given to each objective. Yes, so you can see that this question is nothing but the application based question. If your understanding is clear about the concept, then easily you can solve such kind of questions. Mr. Raj offers student praise whenever they show that they are on task. So here Mr. Raj is using what management strategy? Option number A, that is shaping. Option number B, that is controlling the student behavior. Option number C, that is reinforcement. And option number D, that is prompting. So here what Mr. Raj is doing, he's praising the students. Okay, whenever they are on the task. So this praising, it is related to the, it is a type of reinforcement. So automatically here we are going to lock option number C as a correct option. Time management is important too. And the options are student only, teachers only, higher level managers only, and the option number D, that is everyone. And of course, the time management, so here we are talking about the related to the school or the school management context. But the time management, it is important to everyone. So here we are going to lock option number D as a correct option. Okay, let me tell you one thing, that if we see, I took very less questions based on different topics like time management, event management, concept of management, and Henry Fayol's theory of management, because already I have made different videos very deeply on this particular topics. So link of this video I'm going to share in the description box. Just click on that and you will get access of those videos also. So please remember this. Which of the following is true statement regarding time management? And the options are, four options are there. Option number A, time management means always doing more than one task at the same time. B, time management is about planning to get tasks done and doing them. C, good time management means never taking breaks. D, one way to manage your time well is to ignore daily deadlines and focus on doing the most fun activities. Yes. So here we can use the elimination factors or elimination of the options. So first we are going to eliminate the option number D, that is one way to manage your time well is to ignore deadlines. So time management, in time management, we cannot ignore deadlines because we have to complete the task within time. So automatically we are going to eliminate the option number D. Yes. Let's think about the option number C. Good time management means never taking breaks. So it is not possible because for the effective or for the productive work, we should have some breaks in between. So again, we are going to eliminate option number C, that is good time management means never taking breaks. Then for option number A and 2, we have to select one option. Yes. Let's think about the option number 1. Time management means always doing more than one task at the same time. So here the time management, they are talking about the multitasking, means the multitasking. So to manage the time, the one way, that is the multitasking. Okay. And let's again think about the B option, that is time management is about planning to get tasks done and doing them. Yes. So automatically the time management, it is not related to the multitasking, but it is more related to the planning to get tasks done within the time and doing them. Okay. So here we are going to lock option number B as a correct option. The question is, which of the following is good time management strategy? The options, option A, forgetting about deadlines. B, thinking about the consequences of your actions when you prioritize your task. C, never looking at the schedule or to-do list and just doing the task as you remember. And D, keeping your phone next to you while you study. Actually, we are very habitual of whenever we are doing our task, we are just keeping our phone, not aside, just near us. So automatically, we are going to eliminate this option number D first. Let's think about the remaining three options. The first option number A, that is forgetting about deadlines. So to do any task in time or for the good time management, we have to follow the deadlines. So automatically, we are going to eliminate option number A. Then just see option number C, that is never looking at a schedule or to-do list and just doing the task you remember. Okay. So this is not a time management because we have to do the task as per the priority. Only one option is left with us. Let's see that option, that thinking about the consequences of your action when you prioritize your task. So on the basis of the priorities, and also we have to think about the consequences of the actions, whatever actions or whatever tasks we are going to do. So on the basis of both, we have to think about that. Okay. So automatically we are going to select option B as correct option. Inspiring the staff is a good reflection of which type of skill? And the options are negotiating skill, leadership, project management, and budgeting. Okay. So here, inspiring the staff is a good reflection of which type of skill. And whatever options are given there, we are going to select option number B, that is the correct option, that is leadership. Because inspiring the staff, if we see the definition, it is there in the definition of leadership. So here we are going to select option number B as a correct option. This question, it is related to the event management. So whatever steps of event management are there, it is given here. And you have to select the correct sequence. So the steps are, there is a shuffling, yes. The steps are develop an event concept. The second is set objectives. Third is determine the feasibility of an event. Fourth is planning and preparation. Fifth is identify and distribute tasks and responsibility. Sixth is event marketing plan and implementation of event. And the seventh is post-event analysis. Okay. So here we are going to select option number B as correct option. See, let's see the sequence of this. So first is we have to develop an event concept. Yes, the event concept should be developed first. Then there is a next step is that is statement number three. Determine the feasibility of event. So before setting objective, we have to determine the feasibility, the flexibility of an event. So the option number will see 1, 3, 2. Okay. And the sequence is like 4, 5, 6, 7. So one, develop an event concept. The second is determine the feasibility of an event. The third is setting of objective. Fourth is planning and preparation. Then there is identification and distribution of tasks and responsibilities. Then there is event marketing and the implementation of the event. And last is the post-event analysis. So these are the different steps of the event management, and the current sequence is option number B. Event manager should have planning skill and implementation skill, convincing and negotiating skill, C is creative skills, and last, that is D, all of the above. So here we are going to select option D as correct option, that is all of the above, because event managers needed all the skills: planning, implementation, convincing, negotiating, creative, etc. Yes. Again, I request you, if you really like this video, please like this video, share this video with your friends. I have already shared different links of the videos in the description box. Share those links with your friends. If you are new on the channel, please don't forget to subscribe our channel. Don't forget to press bell button so that you will get notification of the upcoming videos. And if you really like this video, please write your comment in the comment box. If you want to give any suggestions to me, please write your suggestions in your comment box. And if you want any other videos on any other topic, please, you're always welcome. Please put your comments on the comment box. Thank you very much.